Here we can visit mt.com/ind360, where we can navigate to the IND360 downloads page, which has lots of helpful files, including our PLC device description file, along with our sample code and engineering note. This engineering note explains how to use the sample code, how the PLC tags are structured, and how to use the function blocks. So the function block we'll be focusing on today is the wait processing block. So first thing is we're going to go to the web server of the IND360 where we can set many different parameters, but we'll focus here on the industrial Ethernet settings. So we'll select Profinet for this video here today, and then the block format can be 2 or 8 block. Supervision we can enable or disable to let us know if the PLC were to become disconnected. So with that set, we will go into a new project in TIA Portal. All we've done so far is added our controller to the project. And the first thing we're going to do is make sure that the IND360 GSDML file has been installed. On our system, it has. If it has not been on your system, you can find that file again at the downloads page from the beginning of the video. So we'll find IND360 in the catalog, and we will just make sure that we add the proper block format that we already configured in the web server previously. So here that'll be the 2-block format. We'll simply connect that to our controller. And we'll go into the settings of the IND360. So we can note here the input and output addresses, which we'll come back to when we're configuring our PLC tags later. For now, let's go into the properties. And we will look at the IP address, and we'll actually change the Profinet device name here to add an _01. So we'll save this project, and we will compile and download to our controller. Now when the download completes, I would expect to see some errors because while we did tell the project what to expect for the IND360 IP address and device name, we did not actually assign it to the IND360 yet. So we can see here we do have some errors as expected. And we can look at what the exact error is to see that an I/O device is not found as we would expect. So we'll go ahead and find that on our network, the IND360. And we will assign the IP address and the Profinet device name. So the IP address is the default used by the 360, but we'll assign it anyway just to be sure. And then the device name again is IND360_01. And make sure that we hit the assign name button at the bottom. As soon as we do that, we've got green check marks the whole way down, and we are communicating between the devices. So we'll go ahead into our watch table. You can see on the right side of our screen now we've got an actual scale and a local display for IND360. On the left side, we've got a floating point weight value along with status information. So you can see as we add and remove weight from the scale, our PLC weight value is going to match the local display we see on the right side of the screen. We'll go offline and let's go ahead and incorporate elements from our sample code. So we'll add the sample code as a reference project here so we can copy and paste the elements that we might need so that we can use that wait data processing block. So we'll go ahead and we will copy and paste all of the PLC tags from the sample code project into our new project we've been working on so far. Once we have that, we'll go to the PLC data types and once again copy and paste all of the data types found in the sample code. And finally, we'll come to the program blocks. Here's where we can sort of pick and choose the program blocks that we need. We don't necessarily need to copy and paste every element here into our project since we're only going to be using the wait processing block. So we'll paste that there and we can go into that block. We can see network one looks okay. We've got some errors on networks 2 through 7 because it relies on things we did not copy and paste. So we'll go ahead and actually delete those from our new project. Now that we have that, we'll simply go into our main program block and tell it to go into that MTIND application that we were just looking at. All right, and we can save once more. And again, we'll just take a look at our devices here. Going into our IND360 settings, here's where it's important to know those input and output addresses. So we simply copied and pasted the PLC tags from the sample code. It's not guaranteed to match the actual addresses from your 360. So we want to kind of go line by line to make sure it's going to match here so we can read all of that data correctly. So we can see here the command value actually starts at 64. So we'll change that from 68. The command is actually 70 instead of 74. Everything else looks okay until we get to the status block command. Instead of 82, it's actually going to be 78. So we'll simply change that. And now with that set, we'll once again save, compile. As long as there's no errors, we'll download it again to our controller. So here we'll go online. You can see we've got our real-time wait and our stable wait. Stable wait only updating when there's no dynamic weighing values. And those will add. As we add and subtract weight values, those will change as expected. So we can see on the right side, we have other status indications, such as if the weight, the scale is in motion, if our data is okay. On the left side, we have some control options. So here we can actually tear the scale by simply toggling the tear bit. And you can see now, even though we've got weight on the scale, we're at 0 kg net weight. So we are only looking at the net weight from whence we teared the scale. So here we can actually clear the tear by toggling the clear tear bit. And it's as simple as that to control our scale from the PLC using the sample code.